Hello guys, we're moving on with our analysis of chapter 6, and in this video we are discussing dollar value in different times. So you heard before when your parents told, oh, I remember when I graduated from college I was paying 80 cents for a gallon of gas, or your grandparents probably said that, oh, I remember when we were paying for cup or for a can of Coca-Cola 5 cents. So how can we compare this price of Coca-Cola many years ago that your grandparents or your parents were paying 5 cents for Coca-Cola to a price of Coca-Cola that we're paying today? Remember, in the economy over time we do experience inflation, and therefore the price of the product is going to increase. Our question is the dollar buying you the same amount of goods and services today if to compare with the same dollar that we were spending many years ago? And in order for us to understand that, we're going to take an example. Example is going to be with minimum wage. So minimum wage in 1963 was $1.25, and minimum wage in 2013 was $7.25. Our question is, if we're going to take a person who was making $1.25 in December 1963, and that person is going to take this $1.25 and go to the grocery store, okay, is he buying the same amount of goods and services with that $1.25 as the person who is making $7.25 today, or vice versa? We can ask, well, whoever is making $7.25 today, if he's going to take the $7.25, go to the grocery store and purchase some kind of goods, will he be able to purchase the same amount of goods that the person was purchasing with $1.25 in year 1963? So, and in order for us to understand that, this is pretty much, we're going to discuss the purchasing power of your money. So in order for us to understand that, we need to use a formula, and the formula that we're going to use is going to be the following. You are welcome to write it down. You need to know this formula for the test. The formula states like this: amount in today's dollars equals amount in year T multiplied by this ratio. And the ratio, it says over here, price level today over the price level in year T. So guys, price level today is the same as CPI today, and then price level in year T is the same as the CPI in year T. And guys, today refers exactly, in this example we're going to use it as year 2013. This is like the most recent year. And price level in year T, or this amount in year T, this is some kind of amount in the past. So this T refers that this is going to be some kind of amount in the past. This is the year that you need to use it. And the information that is given to us, so once again, we have these 2 years, 1963 and 2013. We have minimum wage in 1963 that was $1.25. And we have CPI in these 2 years. CPI in year T, or in 1963, was $30, was 30.9, and CPI in year 2013 today was 234. So what we need to do, we need to take this amount, this $1.25, and transfer it in today's dollars, or transfer this amount in year 2013 dollars based on these two CPIs. So guys, remember, we have the formula in front of us. I'm going to write it down again. The formula that we're using to transfer $1.25 into 2013 dollars is the following. I'm going to write it down. Amount in today's dollars equals amount in year T multiply by CPI today divided by CPI year T. So let's see what is going to happen over here. So amount in EAT, what are we working with? We're working with this $1.25. So this is some kind of amount in the past. People were making $1.25 per hour. Now, inflation happened over the course of these years, and we calculate our consumer price indexes. So consumer price index today is $234. It's not dollars, 234.6. Remember, this is an index. And we divide this by 30.9. This is our CPI in EAT. And if we're going to calculate all that, it's going to be equal to $9.49. So that's the amount. Let's analyze what we did over here. So based on this formula, dollar figures in different times, you're going to use this formula for the test. We transferred the purchasing power of minimum wage in year 1963 into the purchasing power of 2013 dollars. Based on these two consumer price indexes that BLS were calculating, you know, over the years. So we took amount in year T and multiply by the ratio of these two price levels. Okay, so CPI in today's dollars over CPI in year T, and we got $9.49. So guys, if we're going to compare the minimum wage that people were making, remember from the previous slide, they said that the minimum wage that people were making in 2013 was actually $7.25. The purchasing power of minimum wage in 1963 in today's dollars is $9.49. Who is better off? People who were making minimum wage in the year 1963 or people who are making $7.25 in year 2013? And the answer is people who were making $1.25 in year 1963 are actually better off, because we took that amount, we transfer in today's dollars, and it's giving us $9.49 versus people who are making minimum wage today. Remember, today it's year 2013. They're only earning $7.25 in minimum wage. So therefore, $1.25 had actually more purchasing power than $7.25 in this minimum wage today. So let's look over here. I think it's giving us the answer. Yes, it's giving us the answer. This is $9.49. Once again, we transfer this 125, multiply, they're doing the same thing. They multiply by the ratio and they get $9.49. Once again, this is in 2013 dollars.